Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Landscapes of Enderal, Powder Desert, which I found here in Liliath's house in Rivervale. Landscapes of Enderal, the Powder Desert, a guide by the Golden Sickle for travelers and merchants. If one was to name the most inhospitable and at the same time the most thriving part of all places in Enderal, one would probably choose the Powder Desert. The term encompasses a wide area of southeast Enderal and might fool the visitors of this region. Part of the Powder Desert consists of sandy dunes punctuated by rugged rocks and nasty sand winds. Yet another part is a hardly passable undergrowth of palm trees and tendrils of all kinds, shaped by exotic blossoms and dangerous monstrosities. They decided to call this region Powder Desert, because at the heart of this hot and almost always cloudless area lie the powder mines, where from deep shafts resources are gathered. From those an explosive concoction is made, which is used for cannons and bursting charges. You can reach the Powder Desert if you go to the port first, coming from Ark. Now and then ships depart toward the desert. More reliable for the adventurer, however, is the path near the coast, from which you can reach the port of Ark. Such a journey towards the Powder Desert, mind you, is only advisable for those kinds of people that are well-equipped and experienced in combat. The trails there and thither aren't hard surface and are under a constant threat of pathless ones and monstrosities. Some other path, which is just a bit longer, takes you through Wellwatch straight into the Powder Desert. That icy mountain pass above Ark has to be overcome, yet from Wellwatch you can get to the south, to a giant Kolor. A multitude of paths leads to the Powder Desert, and more often than not, one can find routes among them which are not easily recognized as such. Therefore, it is in vain to try to get exact directions. The caravans, which go there from time to time, know the routes by heart. For strangers, however, only some signposts are of any help, for which you should look for on your travels. But don't feel awkward when you lose your bearings. If your endurance suffices, all routes will lead to one place or another. On the southeast end of the desert, you will find Duneville, which is a quite wondrous village. The surroundings of Duneville are an uncomfortable and inhospitable place, because there are thick sandstorms at all times, and not much can grow there. It would be flabbergasting when there, of all places, men would settle, if it wasn't for the huge freshwater lake, which lies inside a cave deep below the desert ground. The settlement is hard to spot or to find from the outside. That is because it is buried in a pit inside the sand. At the same time, people there are living in the cave's interior on planks. The only place in the Powder Desert where one can trade is Duneville. It is also the only Mirad landing spot far and wide. You should always equip yourselves well when you want to start a journey. The paths are long. In former times, the village Silvergrove was a second hub of civilization, yet in these distant parts, no one dwells anymore these days. If you are still drawn to that place, you can make your way from the powder mines. The southern coast, on the other hand, is a true shelter of life, because here on the beach you can find palm trees and fruits in abundance. Duneville also gets a majority of its food from the shore, which is harvested from wild plantations by supply vessels. Among them you could find oranges, dates, coconuts, but also small quantities of peaceweed, which has an intoxicating effect. From this place some shipments go all the way to Ark. People there very much like these southern fruits. An inhospitable yet interesting place lies in the center of the desert. If you feel like you are a real explorer and want to go there, the Moonstone Dunes are an extraordinary sight for sure, because here light blue stones glow just like stars between sandy dunes. Between them are leftovers from old civilizations, among them those eerie pylons which bring forward energized rays out of the ground. It goes without saying that no one should ever set foot on the interior of those old devices. After all, the Powder Desert is only a considerable destination for well-equipped treasure hunters and adventurers. It is a rule of thumb that the shady figures that you encounter there are of ill intentions. So heed my advice to travel to Duneville by Mirad, for you won't find much in the remaining region apart from hindrances or even your own death. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, Landscapes of Enderal, Powder Desert.